Hey guys, good morning. I'm gonna start a game with orcs today. We played orcs on our first game after the introduction. So we'll see how they got changed, improved. Some of the things were still, you know, very raw when we played the game at the time. It was still early access. Hey, Rubio. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, huh? So orcs have increased influence by doing damage but have an influence upkeep. So when the units deal damage, they increase the influence, but we also have influence upkeep. VAR is a damage bonus when influence is high. Animosity, units suffer penalty to damage when influence is low. So it's opposite of VAR. Scavengers, units salvage ore by killing units. Yeah, I'm gonna modify the settings. Green Tide, units have increased hit point regeneration, and cities have increased growth. This is, you know, the thing that is missing in Warhammer, Total War. Orc with fungus, grow fungus fields that heal orc units. Mob rule, infantry lose less morale but take damage for losing morale. And here we go, infantry units can run to traverse long distances. So, orcs have quite a bit of stuff. They have to have quite a bit of stuff so they can actually get into the flavor and what it means to be orcs. Niblet green. Niblet green, boys. Niblet. Gonna be playing very hard. Large world size. Put a landmass to high. Last was very high. Game pace, keep it on standard. No quests. I'll put the wild up density to high. Artifact density is still very low. This is how I prefer it. The rest of the settings, medium, it's fine. So, large is for 6 players. I hope there are Space Marines in the game. Have one of each. Then we'll add another Space Marines. Another Astra Militarum. Okay, so we it's a 6 factions on a large map. It's last time we played with the orcs was like I think normal. We played normal with orcs. Next game we put it in the hard, I think. But do they get a large loyalty advantage game? I think it's like 20 or 25. It's quite a big deal in the beginning. Let's go with this. A very hard difficulty, large hold size, high landmass, standard game pace. Haven't tried any slower than standard. Don't really feel I need to play any slower than standard. High wild density and a very low artifact density with everything else on default settings. And no quest, of course. The quests could be just beneficial. You could just, you know, get some benefits and ignore doing them. And also, Lotus Skulls, if you're defeating, get 10% damage reduction. This is disabled when there is no quests. So Lotus Skulls appears to closest to the strongest faction, I think. So it balances things out. Yeah, let's do it. It's been like, what, 5 weeks this game was released.
Stupid humans! Building all these big things just for us to smash them. They didn't see us coming. But then, neither did we. Maybe your steering weren't so good. And at least we got a good fight out of them. Even when the teen boys turned up, the boys was happy. Extra fighting! But whatever that thing in the sky is, it don't stir an orc. We's not trapped here. They's trapped with us!
That's the best opening. The best opening. Okay. Oh, look at this fermentation pool next to our capital. Extra food and growth. It's like we're not growing already fast enough. This is probably the best thing to get when you're playing Space Marines. I mean, not the best. It probably, but it is the best. Start with three boys, and Max. Gonna be a lot of ore here. Doesn't really look very good for the food, though. Probably the best thing to get here would be... I don't even know what would be the best for the orcs. This would be the best for the Space Marines. Let's find a city. Start with a little less loyalty. Yeah, we'll work around that. Looks like there is a water here. Ooh. What is 9 there? Looks like we are very far to the west, and there's a lot of water in the south. Nice looking position here for now.
Oh my god! Have you seen that shit? Holy shit!
Hello, Fury. So, the tile where we build the city has 3 slots, and we start with 2 scrap sheds and boss tower. So we can still build one more thing on this tile. Probably gonna be best to build a food building on this tile, because the rest of it it's pretty bad for food. Hmm. Yeah, let's grab this one here. Build the pile of Daka. Orcs, the boss units are pretty good. They have 6 soldiers. Melee weapons, range weapons. So their effective range is melee range, one range. The only problem is they have 2 armor. But the orc technology for armor, I think it's plus 2 armor. So once they get it plus 2 armor, it's a big deal. Orcs. Or the orc with fungus. This is how we bow the food output. Where are we gonna go here? Commander camp is for heroes and generates influence and loyalty. Our first hero is the war boss. I'm gonna play with Pain Boy more than last time. Production of pile of dark is like 10%. Look at with the cool of speed. So speed. Unit costs 1, boys cost 1 food and 2 influence upkeep. Get plus 4 influence per combat from upkeep factor. 50% more healing grade because of the green tide. The unit loses some hit points instead of morale, so 1 hit points per morale loss, 50% less morale loss. You get more melee damage, and we get ore killing enemies. Plus 2 ore per kill value. We have some research here. Oh, influence. Not bad. 1, 2, 3, 4. Within the range of the capital. Look at that damage. Have 25 influence. Gained 8. This is because it's 2 influence upkeep on this unit, so it's 4 times 2 to 8. Some trader encampment here. Should then put it to 41. I could have used Here We Go here. Then still attack the guy. Just an oversight. A pile of darker here. Oh, the crude hounds are scared. See the lack of armor here. Don't do any armor penetration. Oh, some research, and we got the volcanic shroud. Not a very good item. Red influence increasing. Hey, Bress. Oh man, they can actually kill the boys there. Those dirty bastard crude hounds kill my boys there. That was only oversight because they didn't use Irvigor to attack initiative there. They would have been alive. They could have used Irvigor and then would have had an extra moment to attack them. Yeah, I'm enjoying this game. There was an Imperial Bastion side. Look at this map, man. It's beautiful. Beautiful. A bit of water helps. We're going to need three things here anyways. Let's get the stick bombs. Got some ore and energy here. Our wall. One is the bronze wall. Vaughn level 4. Is based on accumulated influence and influence upkeep in a refresh at the start of the turn. It's the core of being an orc. No Castellan robots, that's good. The landmass is on high in this one. I decided I like a little water. Castellan robot might be in the north, so we're not going there. Breaking pipes for energy. Some of them boys. Population. Scrap sheds give to population. The boys have only 2 armor. They are very, very aggressive. Oh boy. You don't care about hey bolters. Not with this armor. So let's get tank busters. The anti-armor infantry. Some scorpions here. This thing is does not get Overwatch. Wow, it didn't attack me. What the hell? Need more orcs. We only have a Vaughn level 5, so we get 25% damage. Which is pretty significant. This thing has fear, so lowers melee damage. get another ore building. I used this here we go in the beginning of that one to move to Crot Hounds, we will save that third boys. It's the ability so they can push themselves for one more movement. Down to level 4. This must be a glitch. So, attacking devil gets close to you, uses Amulet of Wrath but doesn't attack. Center. I don't know, if nobody comes here, we can handle this. Another unit of Crot Hounds, some grenades. Is back to 5. Ink busters are going down. They're anti-armor infantry, they have rocket launchers. They do have lower, I think they do have lower range than the hell game. Can't click on the unit. Yeah, they have lower range than the heavy weapon squad, but they do not have heavy. It's enemy vehicle 6 at 1 on penetration. Oh, they nerfed the armor technology. Wasn't it like plus 2 before? I think it was plus 2, because I seen the boys with 4 armor. Hounds. Get ugly for these guys. Hell shit. Oh, there's another armor? Okay, okay. That makes sense. Orcs dead. Crot Hounds murder boys. We orcs, we don't know what retreat is. Fire is on level 5 and that's all that matters. God damn, 1 HP. They hear something, some vehicle. Imagine, no way nobody has vehicles here to connect with us. Let's claim the growth tile. Gonna put that growth quite absurd. Lagas and Chopas, no arm penetration. But I'm not into boys. Go get Tank Buster. I got 20 health here. In Total War Warhammer 2, is there any tier 4 or 5 units that are useless? Or they can all be utilized with the right tech and lore skills? You can always go try hard micro unit and get some performance. Like the tier 5 Trollhammer Torpedo or the Gara Bombers. But there are other units which fit their role much better and perform better. Much more worth your micro time. Definitely units like that. Like, Help Abomination is like a very underwhelming unit, but at least you can just leave it there and it will tank and do some damage, while it will never really perform well. Yes, you can call them, you know, hit on miss design, and some of them did not hit. More ore and energy. I don't know what is here, so we should not really go for it. Only two boys. Okay, they didn't see us. Humbles have armor. Don't have a tank buster here. Surprise! That thing got deleted. That extra ore and extra influence is nice to get. This faction is supposed to get influence fighting. Negative is no, going negative is normal. Make BTRs in 2 turns. Let's get the cult of speed. Start with extra population compared to other fact. Population slots. This should be some like a might be just even a peninsula here, and we are safe in the south. So this might be like the war zone. Don't see us in the forest. Scorpion is, I think, yeah, boys the glass cannons, they get more armor, yeah. I agree with that. They're really cheap. And they do the job. Need some more research, man. It's way too. We can go for data. We can just, I don't know, maybe we should. I don't think anybody spawned here. This is the corner. Orcs really need that one research building early. Make a prepare and pack here. For the Horde. I mean, for the war. Akadama. Let's let this guy eat Overwatch here. There's a stolen robot there, that's nasty. We can't let get flanked by this. You guys might be dead if they can stun the robot from the scene. Thing is hard to kill. Another stun robot? Oh boy. Little pay probably took 2 lives here. Hey, Bolter is killing my orcs. I tank busters is here. They have 5 rocket launchers. Orcoid fungus gives us hit points, okay. Me have war buggies. We have some ore. And a research building. Any % research there? Why not? The river, it will cannot cross extra. Yes, they might as well heal there. More boys. Scorpion is healed. Hopefully there are no crude hounds in the area. I think it's all again gonna survive on low health. It's just debating us. The armor tank busters. They have one less guy. After it. Getting war bugs in 3 turns. We see the Imperial Guard here. Which means there are no more wildlife here. Orc is better than Morgul. Well, it's easy to say that when we don't have any goblins. I'm not gonna engage there yet. I don't know, maybe. A good partner map here. Could be good for energy. 4 buggies is our vehicle unit. This is a QRSM adjacent to an allied unit. Outflank. And it has 2 twin-linked big shooters. Shooter is basically like a last gun, while the big shooter is a multi-laser. In terms of damage. Make bit yards as the on the next building. What you hiding there, friend? Don't worry, we won't kill you hard. Still slow. Yeah, another Jokero trader encampment. Heavy armor in 2 turns. Might have they have more crew hounds. Easy to kills. Our units have high damage. It might be Akutama. Rain music? What are you talking about? What red music? Or bug is a tanky, 6 armor, 32 health. Get some experience here. Heavy armor, so the boys get, look at that, plus 2 armor. Yeah, but they get like 5 total. Specific to the boys and the war boss, double our armor. Doesn't work on tank buses, but I think tank buses have a different infantry armor, so all infantry get extra armor. It's specific to the boys and the war boss. Wagon is tier 5, huh? We need Grotz huts. Population. Research is good now. Good enough. Hey, John. towards the Imperial Guard. There are two Castellan robots that I've seen here. This is Imperial Guard here. Some Orquid fungus here. Above the accuracy here. And damage you get here, 12. Pretty good, six grenades. Uh-huh. This is the end of the map here. Fungus here so we can get some healing. They are regenerating the fungus. Another committing relay pipe, so we don't even get the energy building yet. Oh, what do we have here? Some tech priests. Lake there. Damage, there's still two of them alive. Can I save, see what is going on here? We are far from everything. Preamble, so not good. Overwatch. Just two Castellan robots, three Castellan robots, wow. This is gonna be a problem. One of them is level 2, gotta kill. Rots huts. Our population building. This has an incendiary combustor and a twin link heavy phosphor blaster. I think it's made to fight infantry and vehicles. Yes, John. Enslavers, not the enslavers. Moment artifact. That's a convenient one to find. Under camp. Oh, rip bug is. Slaver's work especially good against the orcs. Can't deal with those three castellan robots right now. Should just ignore that corner until we get some more firepower. Yeah, you get max. What's in the Grotz huts? The neutral unit here. We have to fight our own war buggies. Not like this. Guys needs to heal. If we invest in this area here, we don't have any 3 range weapons. We might get attacked by another faction. Our AP right now is not that impressive. Pain boy. Can't go there, us enslavers are there. There are 3 Castellan robots here. No ore fields, huh? I sent everything there, we might have enough to bring it down, but who knows what else is there. Stone robots are too sturdy for our firepower right now. 3 of them. shit. The 20% damage artifact. Just what we need. Get a become even glossier cannon. And it's in our corner. Mine! This is a top priority tech, this is a game changer. 3 Castellan robots. Holy shit, look at that shit. Don't have the firepower to do that. There's enslavers there as well. Slayers are like the worst nightmare in the other game for the orcs. Maybe we can pull one of the robots. If we damage down, just gonna flee. There's also influence and food here as well. It's good for a great sort of high, big city. Could be also a science city there, research. Like, too many casualties here. We'll lose all our military if we go here. This artifact is too good. Some Overwatch here. Maybe there is no enslavers there, maybe just wasps. Pain boy, this is our one of our support heroes. So it costs us 40. Can do quite a bit of damage here. Even tank bust around. There's a cliff. Damage from the tank busters. So I'm probably gonna be forced to retreat. Production of mech yard. Big bits yards. Loyalty building, dev copters. I think bastards can throw anti-armor bombs. Get the killer cans. They're gonna be rotating these bastards. I just got my boys there. Yeah, the thing bosses can't take damage from this shit. This is 7 health, we might have enough. Enough damage there. This thing is down to 4 health. This is a good place for the energy. Energy outposts. I mean, some of them are gonna be claimed in later game. Another Castellan robot? What the hell? One was trying to repair somewhere. City here. But this is where we get energy. City specializations, remember? I don't plan to build any energy here. What is this? 16 health. Orc, Gork. Let's shoot. Let's slowly bring him down. That artifact is too important. We need to clear this area before we get into a conflict with our faction. Kill this thing, we're gonna get a lot of experience. Oh man, he's gonna live. They can't retreat, they can move here. One health, god damn it! One health! Not like this! This is going down. It's like 3 units of wasps here. One more is damaged there, we have them. This guy doesn't miss the kill. Lost morale here as well. It's a 20% damage artifact there, it's like top priority to get. We're investing everything to get it. See, our Imperial Guard, he doesn't mean they're close. Building. That one is getting repaired every turn now. Might be. Only slayer, just wasps. That's good news. Someone has to take Overwatch here. Why do orcs lose health sometimes when attacked? Infantry has this thing called mob rule. So they lose health per morale loss, but they lose 3% less morale when losing morale. So they don't have much morale issues. But they, instead of losing, you know, the accuracy earlier, they all infantry takes damage instead of losing extra morale. Wasps or Wurmbled Grenades? We got this, we got this. Oh, there were no enslavers here, I was worried there was a wasp on enslavers. This artifact, oh man, it's a good one to find for the first one. There's one here for the moment, which is also not bad. A good Overwatch here. Wasps are not really deadly, they're just a harassment. One of them harassment wildlife creep. I'm not sure why I was attacking that one first. Can't capture artifact because there is a Castellan robot next to it. Next turn. Food. Oh, there's enslavers there. There was enslavers there, huh? Black hands. Percent damage with the wall plus 45% damage. Boys are restless. Slayer, it's no big deal. We got Va. Be organized. We just have to catch that the robot with his fleeing. Need a loyalty building here. Fighting pits. That's the Mega Slugger. Come back, Metal Thing. Let's fight. Don't be like that. Can't tease the boys like this. We're gonna fight next, man. It's like nobody to bash there. Uzdaka, Vazdaka. It's very good for research here. Fighting pits for loyalty. See the Overwatch here. Some experience there. That happens. Loyalty also. Nine turns. It's scrap sheds as well. Yeah, okay, food here. Yeah. I can increase the food production here. crap sheds in every city and then get everything produced faster. I wonder if this is the end or there's a connection down there. Are there, I got to kill a can. 11 turns, holy shit. The loyalty is crushing us right now. Should have had a loyalty building already. Loyalty building before the third city. Losing influence as well, there's no fighting. Heavy bolters are very good against war buggies, so we need some support. Research pretty good. Oh man, imagine if it was a dead end here. Looks like a dead end. That would be a pretty cool map. Look at this huge inner sea here. Might be, might be a connection, huh? Enslaver down there. Let's see what's here. There's some scouting party. Broke, you know, a huge army of Imperial Guard to get murdered. We do have some anti armor. But most importantly, we have extra 45% damage. Looks like we're gonna be taking a lot of damage here. 6.2. Still no casualty though. This was like a good protection against whatever would come here. But Impel Bash. What the hell? One of the Impel Guards got deleted. That's not the Impel Guard next to us though. Probably in the other corner. Maybe it's not even smart to attack this. But I wanna see what's down there. We the boys, we curious. You're not like the Imperial Guard and the Space Marines when ignorance is bliss. Poke the guard here, but I think it's too early to go in engagement. Don't have that any significant advantage, but our boys need fight. Ah, If it can be streamed, yeah, why not? It's really hard for me to play anything offline. See what we get there. Get kill against Nathan's. We like have serious loyalty issue right now. I have to pull out here. Yeah, bullets are good against Think Busters. Craft Sheds is the production building which produces other buildings. Two is like optimal to have in the city. You start with one. We're gonna have to pull out here to repair. The slaver here, the artifact for movement. Oh boy, there's a city here. I do hope they have another enemy. They might have expanded there. This area will not go. My production is too low right now. Low. We should leave this bottleneck here. Now that I see the city here. Blind grenade. I got a battle wagon and extra infantry. Let's start with extra infantry armor. Put our boys to 5 armor. Look how deadly the heavy bolter is to the tank busters. We'll leave this actually. So it's a good bottleneck. Mechs have the ability called Mech Tools, similar to the Tech Priest Engineers. They can repair vehicles or fortifications. Nobody's here. I need Overwatch here. It's a movement artifact. This is not an army, this is a rebel. Rebel. Rubble. Rebel. Rubble. Rubble. We got that enslaver. That movement order for this is pretty good. Oh, scout sentinels. Level 3. Basilisk. I will pull out. Don't have anything to do with, to deal with Basilisk right now. Unless we can get closer and hit it. Umis. Squishy pink Umis. They don't put up much of a fight on their own, but with a few tanks behind them, you could have some fun. Till a better fight comes along. Pity they squish so easy. Oh man. This is the my advisor knows we play on a very hard. Made contact. Plenty of cover here. Loyalty. I need loyalty. A good amount of scrap. Research is good. This is a population limit and influence. It's actually a loyalty buff here. We should get closer to that. It's 10 turns to produce. It's a lot. We need more food. Population costs food, we have 3 cities. Steady food supply. Vehicle so far. They already searched recovery here. It's not even a top priority technology. But when you have AI with that extra loyalty, it doesn't matter, you get the technologies very fast. Doesn't look like there is any major amount of forces here. They also have infantry armor tech. It almost feels like we're getting jebaited here. That extra moment is beautiful. We orcs, we need to keep fighting. Look at that war level 4, it's embarrassing. Get loyalty building here in the next turn so it will buff the production. Makes us so squishy to arm 9 health. Oh, there's a primary psyker. Was the Scryer's gaze. Plus this is very good against the bug, it's too range. But it's vulnerable to melee attacks. They have our tech priests. Not even worth firing there, man. We're not really ready for a siege. But we'll definitely get a good scrap here. It's a river here, huh? Those grenades with plus 45%, 40% damage is huge. Oh, this is low ground. Oh man, I didn't see it. I think Buster's in the front. Looks like there might be their extra cities here. If they send something serious, we can always fall back. Point 6 loyalty. Just take 11 turns to build. Organs. Yeah, we don't have units here to do any siege. Can't damage anything in the city with this. Extra infantry armor, put our boys to 5. Now the boys are good. I think Bastos gets one as well. Mechs get one. We have to get it for commander camp there. Well, this guy not even taking damage in the city. Killer can't take forever to build, man! What the hell? Getting a key influence here. Research is good. Research is good, I'm happy. So far, nothing serious here, but I have the city here, so this is a big advantage for them. There's a lemon in the north. Now, Lord Commissar. Oh, that's a problem. This must be just been produced. Can't find the lemon inside the city. Still get good fighting here. The thing enter the forest. That would be ideal. Just cover in the city. Vehicles don't get the extra cover, that 50% range damage reduction, but they the minimal 30% seat damage reduction. All get that in the city, so it's, you know, they, you know, defenders, you know, have some advantage. What is this is, but it looks like it's coast. And alone food. Casualty. They looks to be sending troops from other side where they are fighting war with somebody else. See who they're fighting there. This is Cliff here, huh? Good for our different unit. Killcans are a vehicle walker. have a King Claw, pretty good melee weapon, and two Scorches, but they're against Kaur. They are really vulnerable to anything with ordnance, even the basilisks, like the battle cannon. The ore and six influence upkeep. Production, man, what the hell? So low. So low. The extra damage you have here is nice. Looks like they're fighting someone on the other side. Shame losing the tank buster there. Like, time to withdraw two Bulgrins. Like, time to withdraw. Yeah, boys, not fighting for now. Don't get patched. Gonna get a commander camp for the pain boy. War boss. Good Overwatch. Ten tank is doing too much damage to us. Lemon. A battle wagon. The battle wagon is just, you know, the classic orc vehicle. Fighting wildlife. This movement is very good for exploring. what's here. I might have been just fighting wildlife. Nine turns, production is so low. Megalops. Hell yeah! Bloody Impelguard repelled us, but we'll be back. Bigger, meaner, greener, and more heavily armed. Looks like nobody taking this yet. We do need all this building. Put here as well. Everyone, good morning. They are dealing with scorpions here. Looks like we had a really good location. Look at this position we got here. That's amazing. Zod High Jerkin, that's a good one. That's a good one. Guess we got it here. Looks like they went all in on us here. Just what we needed, attract all the wildlife from the Imperial Guard. Yes, enough arc. Shit, this position here. Oh, we don't have any heroes yet. guys are in trouble here. Wow, look at this. Let's find our floor field. Blocked us here much. Well, we know what is here. Need some mega knobs here. So too far to go fighting here. Guy's probably dead. This is all high ground and there's a Castellan robot here. The scrap sheds here. Loyalty is minus 12. Yeah. Yeah, I really got in a bad spot here with all this wildlife. Lost all the firepower. Richest and most battle-hardened nobs can become mega nobs by paying a mech to build them a suit of mega armor. Piston driven and covered in enough protective plating to turn its wearer into a walking tank. This armor is incredibly expensive. It serves as the ultimate greenskin status symbol. Though other orcs mock the mega nobs for wearing so much armor, only the dullest would do so within earshot. Even a direct hit from a tank round is unlikely to do more than a knock a mech nob over. Worst thing is already foul temper. For many, the only chance of surviving an encounter with an angry mega nob is to outrun him. 11 armor? What the hell? Love me some mega nobs. Man, look at this position, man. It's so fortified. Okay, most of these wildlife is in the center. Shot here before moving. We might have Overwatch. To go around. Power watch here. They're moving a forest here. I have a guy here, so they'll get hit. Surrounded by the Imperial Bastions and a lot of units. I say one of the buggies. Doesn't look like it anymore. Might as well get some war while we are dying, fighting to die here. So we can grow Orchid Fungus, put output and healing rate on the tile. Damage of bolt weapons. The battle wagon, battle bigger shooters. Guys in deep, and imagine we got we played in Imperial Guard on this map. That's insane. Got this lemon good. Cost like three orcs, you orc boys. Good for the food, loyalty and research. We're also gonna run out of food. Yeah, we need definitely more food. Focus more on food here. That lemon will treat. There's a cliff here as well. This map is crazy. Bellowagon is a armor transport. Hard to kill and can also transport 6 infantry. Starts with a Zev gun. Nothing really special. It's a low accuracy. But once you get the strategic technologies, it gets a lot of weapons. Orcs use a lot of infantry, so the battle wagon is amazing. Research is really good here. Feel like I should get some food here as well. It's a real bad spot here. I'm actually getting big shooters already for the battle wagon. Tickling that Castellan robot with Scorcher. Should go north, enough exploring here. We hit fortifications here with all units. Short break, guys, before we continue. Back in 5 minutes. I'm back, boys. What's the setup for the map? It's a large map, high landmass, very hard difficulty. There are 5 other factions, high wildlife, very low artifacts. Plus, they're pretty good against these walkers. Although my standard setup, I'm still playing around, but I do prefer a very hard, large map. Very low artifacts, absolutely. High violet density, prefer that as well. High landmass, yeah. I actually like a bit of water after seeing the last map. Yeah, pretty much preferred setup, yeah. Might survive if you go to this area. Why are we setting up Kim in medium? Get the orchid fungus here. There's a unit there. We should try to fight for these outposts. Currently can't beat them here because they have better position to defend. But we could definitely fight them here. Why are we doing very high? We could try that. We could try to high very high next 2 games. Just to see how it is. High Wirewood might actually look decent. Oh boy, the fauna zone. Unlucky for that war buggies. I think anything that slows the early and mid game is good. There's no faction should get killed within the first 100 turns. Oh, tank commander, fucking hell. Yeah, the orcs can play as passive as the other factions. Because as you build armies, you're gonna be losing influence. I mean, we don't even have a large army, losing 23. Maybe we can ambush him there. Nice how the orcs can get food anywhere. Yeah, the Necrons would not be bothered much by this.
This train is insane! What the hell? This almost looks like real shit.
This map part of map is scary for the wildlife, and it's the terrain itself also what makes it like that. Need to get the scrap sheds here. Hellwagon big shooters. This adds to the Bellwagon two big shooters. Boys are ready. I mean, we could have definitely used another tank buster though. They've copped us. Yeah, scout. I have grenades 5 turns here. These guys are caught far in deep shit there. There's a Castellan close. We'll have one Twinling be shooter here. When it gets closer, we just send the Bellwagon on them, just ambush them. Bellwagon exists and getting those tank bosses into position. I have two scrap sheds here now as well, nice. We are running out of juice. The juice here. Action is a bit slow. A little speed up here. Another, gonna get to another pile of Daka and, that pile of Daka, cult of speed. They do have Bulgans now, so they might be able to find dealing with the wildlife. Try to repair this, guys. I wanna give this artifact to Imperial Guard. We'll get more juice here. This one need to get build the wood here. Copters, Lag and Finling Big Shooter. They have the guys in the Death Copters, the Orc boys, and they have to get closer to actually shoot with their Slagas. Oh, we found somebody here. Necrons. Good area here for the killer cans. Overwatch here. Are aircraft hidden by the AVs? No, just the ground units that are not skimmers. On here. I'm gonna need a loyalty building. This is the food output of tiles with orchid fungus. Some of this lower stuff. Research is pretty good, and it's adds up as well. Let's see if they respond here. God. Just what we needed here. Those guys must are below us. They might those guys probably did murder the other Imperial Guard. Megan Ops. You don't want to mess with these guys. Orcs have any? I remember that that artillery unit of orcs in the Dawn of War 3. Why did they not put that unit in this game? I feel like orcs need some kind of 3-range, 4-range artillery. Cult of Speed builds aircraft, and you can build early, so you don't need like a higher tier building to build aircraft. But I think they really need one of them tanks. Don't the orcs have tanks in Warhammer 4 Tau? I remember they have some kind of artillery unit in Dawn of War 3. Loot a tank. Oh man, I wish we had some tanks here. Blood lemons. Holy shit. Got a better food now. Oh, this is a good kill. That isn't the artillery from the Imperial Guard. Looks like there's a Necrons here. A Warboss. Warboss has a attack Squig, so he's have a Squigger with him that does more damage in melee. He can increase his hit points. Has a buzz heads for the lower morale of nearby units and a proper wall. Increase the influence gain when dealing with damage units with might makes right in the region. So it's a very solid hero. I'll shop here. It's real deadly in melee. Armed to the teeth, the good shit. That's one advantage of playing the orcs. You can use the trader encampments, spend influence to equip your heroes with good shit. Extra health region. This guy is gonna have his region. What kind of shout? Cause we, you know, had an extra. Why not? Plus 3 armor, 25% attacks, and plus 25% melee damage. This guy is gonna delete people in melee. His range is just, you know, like symbolic. He has a, you know, rocket launcher with him, why not? But having a power claw with a attack squig, this is where the damage comes from. And then we have the war bonus damage and the artifact bonus damage plus the items equipped. I'm not sure it does work on the power claw and the attack squig. This might be a glitch. You know, I wish I would know if they would actually tell you. This concealed weapon system, I'm not sure it works on the power claw and the attack squig. Didn't work last time either. Good army, just needs to get fighting. Could engage here would be great. Play some more watch just in case. I think I cancel this artifact for now. Ball dropped to level 3. boys, restless. Boys, they forgot war boss. Somebody's gonna pay for this shit. With their lives. Actually running out of ore. And I'll get the food. I don't know, man. I feel like we can meet some nasty shit here. Gotta love the Bellwagon. So far, nobody here. Clear this red thing. Red thing. Just poking here, nobody here. Nope, we have weapon squad. Of course, wire weed in the way. We have Overwatch ready, huh? Let him heal there. Let's see what kind of presents they get. Wow, to level drop to level 2. Two more fighting. Docker jets. I have two twin links super shooter. It's like a heavy bolter. Just with a little more damage. I think the damage is applied already from the damage buffs. Bomber was not good before, but I think they actually fixed it. Darker jet is good though. We still have this ore field, nice. Somebody gets here and I get stabbed. I'm not sure how the spawn works. I think maybe the Imperial Bastion, maybe if they control the outpost. Raises the population limit of orc cities. Deep diggers. Put Overwatch here. Ooh, look at them Necrons here, track Praetorians. That green I had chosen for the Necrons looks really intimidating. Half of the people in my family do. I can't tell for the other people. So I guess maybe the same like anybody else, anywhere else. Pain boy, huh?
Oh my god! Have you seen that shit? Holy shit! What the hell?
It's Tanek. Thank you for using your Twitch Prime here. The Pain Boy has some really nice stuff. Dog's tools, healing, extra bits. So within the radius of 4, the infantry costs 25% less energy, food, and ore. And the good stuff, cyborg implants. Permanently increases the damage of. And grants feel no pain damage reduction to the target elite infantry unit. It also has the experimental procedure, which is just a temporary 3 turns with 3%. It's really good stuff. Really good stuff. Need to get him just a little bit more armor. This is enough for him. Get him plus armor, and plus hit points and healing rate. This will double his toughness. Holy hell, he's still not dead. Oh, it's dead. All calculated. Utterly forgot we had another weapon. Oh, you dead too? I don't even need to think, man. You see these orcs, you just believe. You believe you have enough. You click some buttons, you send some boys out, and shit gets done. Loyalty here on. Another pain boy. Hang low on food and ore. I don't feel like it's time to get another city. Production is so low already with disloyalty. Guardsman.
Hey, Deadpool.
Like there's gonna be Necrons here, so we'll just keep the kill cans here. Some ore here. I have a basilisk shooting there. Another one. We are here, boys. Who is the pain boy? The doc. Get this by a few cyborg implants. One. He has a little helper on his back. That's the dog's helper. I didn't even notice this last time. Some scouting. Taken by the Necrons. Necrons, boy. Just double check. First moment. Akajit costs 3 and 6. It's a very good to get the influence. So it has high upkeep. It turns. Boy. Healing over time. Dog's tools from chain scalpels and cranial trowels, nicely weighted mallet. Orc surgical implements are crude yet surprisingly effective. Just need to believe, boys. Just believe it works. guy's level 5, what's the damage? 0.1 or 2.6? Some exploring with this one. Hopefully it does not get targeted by the artillery. Burning juice. Burning way too much juice. Percent loyalty, 20% research. I got it here already. Minus 47 loyal influence per turn. It's kinda a lot. Not sure we can keep this up. We're producing units all the time. We are not fighting anybody here, that's the problem. We get some boys in the action. This is a rough place to fight. And this is even worse. Orcs, orc units cost influence, but they also grant influence depending on how much is their influence upkeep times 4. For example, the Bug is grant 12 influence per attack. Yeah, we got a good Overwatch here. That was what I was hoping for. The orcs don't really need influence buildings as long as you're fighting. So, 24 influence here. 676. See, one attack by the killer can 24 influence. Must be a tank commander here. I see the smoke screen as well. We're not gonna go into that Overwatch. It's baited. It has the vacuum the machine. Might makes right. Another flyer. Just jet bike you into one. More water. All three are vulnerable to tank rounds here. Ordnance weapons. Nobody respawned here yet. Auron loyalty here. Need juice here. Juice and loyalty. Up this too. Wish, you know, they would fix this. This is what is in the transport. Does look a little bad. I wonder if it's actually fixable. I remember the same glitch in what was the game? Same shit. They would remain on tile, and then when you would unload them, they would just. Pretty Gonzalez there. Mhm. Very good. They're still in the wagon, but. It's the visual, just the visual glitch. Don't want to take Overwatch here. Pretty chill orcs game here. Pretty chill. Okay. Gonna be it for the Gladys today, boys. Hundred turns for part one. We'll be playing this again next time. So part one stream will end here. I'm gonna have a break. I think it's gonna be like 40 minutes. And when I get back, we'll be playing Rome 2. Violet Impera. See you guys in about 4 minutes.